Hey, what's going on, my friends? Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Victor, and today I'm going to share with you five signs that you are about to take a quantum leap in your life, contrary to how you might think and feel in this very moment. I know, I at least strongly suspect that deep down, your intuition is already telling you this. It's already telling you that things are good. You are on track. I know how they look. I know what you're thinking, and I certainly know how you feel, but you're in the process of a divine orchestration that you've set in motion, and you've got this momentum going for you, and now it's that time to make that leap. And what you're doing right now is experiencing the shift and transition from one state of consciousness and life experience to another. But that bridge, that middle ground is where people lose faith and question their sanity and wonder what the heck they're doing. This video is for you, my friends, who are on the bridge, who are crossing the bridge, who are almost at the other end of the bridge, but just don't know it, but feel it intuitively. Here are five signs that you are crossing that bridge and are on the brink of taking a quantum leap in your life right now. Number one is you might be experiencing increased sensitivity and certainly having a difficult time staying balanced and neutral within your emotional body and also within your life. Because right now, I would suspect that life is moving very quickly. There's a lot going on, a lot of changes happening in your life at a very quick and accelerated rate. Parallel to that, and perhaps the cause of it, is you are changing dramatically. You are like transforming yourself at an incredible rate right now. So it's almost like you're just sprinting. You're like in a race car going very quickly with the windows down and you can hear the wind. Imagine going down the track at 200 miles an hour, windows down. You've never driven this fast before. You don't even know how you're doing in this race car. And all of a sudden, you're just in that type of experience. So it's okay that you're feeling sensitive. There's a lot of energy, a lot of movement. And this is not the time when you're gonna be the most consistently serene and balanced and zen-like version of yourself. There's a time and a place for that in the near future, but right now is not the time. You're in that race car, and that's a good thing because you're leaving a situation, a life chapter, if you will, that you didn't like. You didn't prefer it. You weren't happy there, and it's breaking down, and you're moving out of it into new horizons, my friend, and you're going there quickly. So that's a good thing. So it's okay that you're going fast. In fact, again, it's a positive thing because you're going to a much better situation very, very quickly. But you are going quickly on all levels. Your experiences are transpiring very quickly, hence the difficulty staying balanced. Number two is oftentimes during this time of your life, there are unexpected changes that kind of fall into your lap. Suddenly. Not bad changes, but just big changes. Changes that make you step back and go, whoa, I'm gonna have to really step back from this and take a moment to process what's going on. What comes to mind when I was writing this down is when I was a young man and I was a personal trainer, I had worked very hard to become a trainer. I got certified over the course of a year. I now found myself at a job and a career that I enjoyed. It was a couple years I was working there. And all of a sudden, one day I come in there and my boss, Bill, says, Victor, by the way, this is your last day. We're closing down. And I'll never forget the phone call I had to make to my wife. I said, honey, I don't have a job as of this evening. So I don't know what we're gonna do, but gotta go. It was a real heavy situation, and it was a big, big bomb that was dropped into my lap. And initially, I was afraid. Like, what am I gonna do? This is my job. I was the breadwinner at that time. But do you know what that big, sudden, sort of initially resisted change did for me? It allowed me to take a quantum leap in my life and career. Because the business shut down, do you know what I got to do? I got to take all of their leads. I was able legally, and it was, I had permission to write down all the numbers of all the clients that this franchise owner had. And I got to call them up on the phone. All my favorite clients I started working with. I started going to their homes and training them. I was able to charge them less. I was able to make a lot more money myself because there was no overhead, and I got to work with the people I wanted to work with at the times I wanted to work with in the way I wanted to do it, and I had all this freedom. My weekly or monthly income doubled, if not more, and everything improved. My life was a lot better. So a lot of times, big, powerful, bold beginnings start with initially a little bit scary and sometimes even painful endings. Number three, and this one might sound a bit unusual. You might find that you're naturally inspired and excited and enthused to start decluttering your house, your car, your life, your closet, your garage, your basement, anything in your life that has literal clutter in it. You will have the intuition and even the motivation to create some more space in your life. What's attempting to come in for you is big. We're not talking about small changes, we're talking about quantum leaps. And this is a game of energy that we're playing right now. And a lot of times we need to create space so our attention and focus will naturally be drawn to areas of our life that are unnecessarily heavy and unnecessarily cluttered. Because those literal clutterings, your messy garage, has an actual energetic weight. And it is like taking up space and occupancy in the totality of your consciousness and, in a sense, your manifestation field. So you want to create as much space as possible. This is not something I'm suggesting you need to write down and make sure you do. I'm saying I bet you're already doing it, probably naturally. And it's probably not even as burdensome as you would normally expect. I know for me, one of my biggest quantum leaps was when I had two careers and I was firmly implanted in a location in Michigan. And I wanted to get rid of both the careers, sell my home, and move across the country. And one of my careers is I was a medical marijuana grower, and my entire basement, the entire basement literally, was built out to be one big series of grow rooms. And at that point I was not growing, but I had all the stuff I had to clean out. It was a huge, huge mess. Sorry, my kids I think are trying to come in. Anyway, my basement was just a huge, huge mess. I mean, there was some serious labor and work that had to be done. And I knew it. It was something I sort of neglected for about a few months. Finally, I went down there and started kind of chipping away at it. And initially it was like this insurmountable obstacle. I thought I would never finish. I was tired. I was going through the intensity, stressed out because of the big transition I was going through. But when I got down there, actually started putting things away and organizing and taking things upstairs to throw away and whatnot, it was actually somewhat enjoyable. And what I really noticed that was surprising to me is every time I made a little chunk of progress, I felt vibrationally lighter. As I was making these chunks of progress, I felt in alignment. I was stressed to the max. I had no money coming in. I didn't know how I was gonna make this big quantum leap. But all I knew is when I was cleaning out this disgusting grow room that I just left for 3 months unattended, I felt all was right in the world. I felt in alignment with my soul's path. And I even started to party with it. I put on some music, I'd bring down some water, and I would like have a good time. And when that basement was finally like empty, I felt so light and so amazing. And it was not very long after that that I was living in a different state, having a different career, and my entire life had changed dramatically in ways and at speeds I could have never possibly fathomed to be humanly possible. Number four. This will also sound weird, but not so much because I bet it's happening right now. But sometimes when it's time for us to make this big quantum leap in our life, you will create the experience as if life is pushing you out of a situation that you know you have no business being in anymore. It's long overdue. You're ripe for this shift and transformation and change. But currently, maybe because of circumstance, you find yourself temporarily dwelling where you know you don't belong, where your energy is so not a match for this old situation that it will create experiences that are manifestations of the dissonance. What the hell did you just say, Vic? I'll explain. Meaning, your vibration has gotten so high that you're on the threshold for making a big shift and quantum leap in your life, as we have discussed. But temporarily, due to circumstance, you find yourself dwelling where in a vibrational vicinity that is much, much lower than where you now are revving at, and that will create. It's like water and electricity, oil and water. It's like that. Okay, so you'll create these experiences that are kind of an expression of the mismatch of the energy. I'll give an example. I personally clung to my medical marijuana grow operation way longer than I knew intuitively I should. But as I continued to do that, as I continued to, by a choice of my own, put myself in the circumstance that I knew intuitively on all levels that it was time to move on from and let go of, there were problems, sort of unusual problems. For example, when I would go down in my basement, that was once a place where I really had a lot of fun, I would feel this negative energy, almost like a fear, like a hug, became haunted, sort of. But that was not just it. So it definitely felt like I should not be here. It feels almost eerie. There was crazy things that would happen when I would go down there. For example, I would come down and check on my girl randomly throughout the day, about four or five times, literally, on different occasions within maybe a span of 1 or 2 months. I had come down and I would always come down when the lights would turn on. And when the lights would turn on, these big 1,000 watt high pressure sodium lights, I would come down and just happen to catch one of the lights on fire within itself. Like it was like a... The bulb was essentially on fire, and if I didn't just happen to be there at the right moment to unplug it, it would have literally exploded or melted through and caused a horrible fire. In fact, some of the bulbs had holes in them from that fire that had already burned through. This happened on 3 or 4 occasions when I just randomly come downstairs. Out of all times, I just so happened to catch it at that maybe 10-second window where that was happening. Also, there would be random water spills. My hydroponic system would malfunction randomly and the whole basement would be flooded. It was just this, and then all the plants, they got all these bugs and mites and root aphids. It was just like this incredibly uphill, miserable battle as I stuck myself in a situation that I knew I should have left long ago. There was a vibrational dissonance and manifestations that resulted. Okay, so if you're having any of these things happen to you, it's okay. It's not the end of the world. It just means that you're it's time to move on, and you don't need me to tell you that. Now, I know what you're thinking. Some of you are saying, I can't move on yet. That's sometimes the case as well, and that's going to be fine. You're not going to be swallowed up by your circumstance, even though it can sort of seem that way. It's energy, it's physics, and it just means you're very, very close to being done with all of that. Number 5, in spite of all this nuttiness going down in your life, you sense strongly, you have a knowing that not only is all okay, but you are like so on track with your ideal and highest life path. And you are literally just in the midst of the change that's going to lead to an incredibly positive and welcomed and just blessed outcome. You know this. Intuitively, even if you don't, your emotions aren't always confirming that. Maybe you have a lot of nerves and anxiety and fear about the unknown, the future. And maybe those are sort of legitimate because you genuinely don't know how this change is going to unfold. You don't have the information or the roadmap yet, but you just sense it deep down that you're good. Not only are you good, but when you're in the flow with that knowing that all is well, you are, there's an excitement, like a, I just know this is a profound turning point in my life and that things are about to get a heck of a lot better. I know it's the time to just remain faithful and diligent and do my best to stay in the flow and just trust the process. My friends, my heart goes out to you. for those who are living this situation that I have lived multiple times in my life. I know it's not easy and I know it's not always fun and it can be stressful, but I don't feel bad for you. I'm actually excited for you because I know where it's going. But just to leave you with some final words, I wrote down here some advice that I wish I would have had someone tell me when I was in the midst of my own transition, and it's very simple, and it's this. I wrote down, it's simple. It took me about 30 seconds to just decipher my own handwriting, but I wrote down, it's simple. Just go with the flow and focus upon the part of you that knows. Just go with the flow. You know what that means? Just go with the flow. Let things happen. Just do the next obvious thing in your life. And if you find yourself getting scattered, just choose to reel in your focus and place it upon the part of you that knows what's happening on a broader, larger context. The part of you that knows that things are about to get a lot better in your life. Dwell there. All right. This has been one of the most challenging videos I've probably ever created. I've had you wouldn't even believe the distractions I've been dealing with. I can hear my 3-year-old screaming now at the top of his lungs. He's not injured, no worries, but I'm gonna take this as a cue and to get the heck out of Dodge and go tend to my life. I hope you got something out of this. I felt very I wanted to get this message out there to you guys because it's very important. Because it's very important that you just continue to ride out this process and let your life unfold, because things are gonna get a lot better, not only for you, but then you can be there for other people who are also going through these shifts that might not be as tuned in as you are. So Godspeed, my friends. Good luck. I'm going to bounce real quick. If you're brand new to my channel, let me say I offer everybody a free guided meditation. I have a couple of them. The one I'm going to offer you today is one that will help you align with your higher self so you can feel connected to your intuition more strongly. It's a guided experience essentially to reveal to you that you're always connected. But once you remember that, once you sort of can experience that connection, then you can recognize it more often when you have it throughout the day. And then you could draw upon your higher consciousness more at will in a sort of practical way for your own benefit. It's a totally free meditation. I made it myself. It's right from my heart. Check it out down below if you'd like. It's at the top of the description box or in that first comment. With that, I'm going to bounce. You all have an amazing day. Namaste.